Welcome children. I hope you have learnt the chapter 4. Yes, about the functions in PHP. Yes. So functions in PHP, we have seen about functions with return values, functions using parameters, everything we have seen, and also the array functions, array loops, everything we have seen. Yes, in this chapter. So we are going to see the book exercises which is being given in this lesson. Okay. First thing we are going to see is the PEP activity. In this PEP activity, we are having small problem that Radha is very excited about the new washing machine at home. She is helping her mother operate the washing machine by following the instruction. What are all the instructions? First one, program selector knob. You can select a program by turning the program selector knob. Temperature selector knob to select a temperature for hot water. Spin button, select a final spin for drying the clothes machine. Start and stop button for closing the door, and press the start button to start the machine. So Radha wants to wash the clothes in hot water but not to dry them in the machine. Which function should she choose? Which function should she choose? What function can she do? Okay. Have you know the answer? Yes. You found out the answer? I think many have correctly guessed the answer. Answer is choose the relevant temperature using temperature selector knob and should not choose spin button. Okay, this is the answer for the PEP activity 4.1. What is the answer? Choose relevant temperature using temperature selector knob and should not choose the spin button. The next one is look within 4.2 activity. Refer to the predefined functions of PHP at the beginning of the lesson. Which among them would be useful to other subjects like maths, science, history and English? Map them in the table given below. So we are having certain predefined functions which is in your book. Yes, you want to match that predefined function with the subjects, any one of the subjects, but which is like maths, science, history and English. Okay, this is your own opinion. You want to match which function is relevant to which subject. Yes, got it? So I think you all can do this look within 4.2 activity. Shall we go to the next activity? See children, you want to write this. Don't leave this empty. You want to write this in the exam. I may ask this question also. Got it? So in your term on examination, I may ask any questions, not alone book back exercises. Inside all the book activities also, I may ask. So be clear with the answers. Yes, children? Okay, we can go to the next activity. The next activity is think and ink. What changes should be done to the code to sort the same array in the descending order? We saw a program for sorting a given elements, right? Last class we saw the PHP program for sorting the given elements using the function, isn't it? Yes, in that also we saw how to reverse, that is how to sort the element in the descending order also. Normal sorting, ascending order, and if you want descending order, the array function name is, instead of array function, you want to use array reverse function for sorting the array in the descending order. Okay, so instead of array function, you want to use array reverse function. Got it, children? This is the answer for think and ink 4.3. Take your pencil and your book. Write the answers for all the activities in your book. Pause the video and write the answers for all the activities. Don't leave it blank. Yes, you can go to the next activity. The next activity is 4.4, that is look deep. What would be the cause and effect if there are no predefined array functions? How will this affect programmers? So, if there are no array functions for sorting, reversing and for everything, many array functions are there, right? Predefined array functions are there for array elements to be considered. So, if there are no such predefined array functions, how will it affect the programmers? That is your opinion. So you want to write it by your own. Got it? Yes. So you want to write it by your own. The next one. PEP activity 4.5. What are the different looping statements in PHP? What are the unique characteristics of each of them? So this is the answer for this. So what are the looping statements? This is called as loops. Okay, these are all called as loops. So loop, while loop, do while loop, for loop, and for each loop. See here, loops. What are the loops available? While loop, do while loop, for loop, and for each loop. And unique character they have asked. So unique characteristics in while loop, evaluates until the expression evaluates to false. Okay, so this while loop will execute the expressions until the expression evaluates to false. Do while loop, it executes the statement first and then tests the condition. Okay, so do while loop, what it will do? It will execute the statement first and then test the condition. For loop will execute the part of the statement specific number of times. So it will execute certain parts of the statement specific number of times. It is the unique characteristics of the for loop. For each loop works only with an array, used to iterate arrays easily. So for each loop works only with the array elements and it is used to iterate array elements easily. Okay, so these are the unique characteristics of the loops available in our PHP programming language. So we are having in PHP programming language, we are having looping statements such as while loop, do while loop, for loop, and for each loop. The unique characteristics, that is the what are the difference, the characteristics of each loop. While loop, it evaluates until the expression evaluates to false. Do while loop, execute the statement first and then test the condition. For loop, execute part of statement specific number of time, and for each loop works only with an array, used to iterate arrays easily. So this is your answer for this PEP activity, which is given in 4.5. This is very important, the difference between all the looping statements. So be clear with the concept of all the looping statements which is used in PHP. Got it, children? So while, what is meant by while loop, do while, for and for each? You know, want to know what are the unique characteristics? This is very important. I may ask the questions in this also. Please read, don't leave this PEP activity. Got it? Yes, I think you are clear with all the looping statements in this now. We can go on to the next one. The next one is think and think. Is this possible to achieve functionality of for each loop using for loop itself? Validate your answer. Is it possible to achieve a functionality of for each loop? No, it is not possible to achieve the functionality using any other loop in PHP. So for each loop is particularly, it is used for array elements to execute, to eradicate the array elements easily, isn't it? So to work with the array elements easily, we are having a loop called as for each loop, but it is not possible to give the same functionality, to achieve the same functionality using your for loop. Okay, for loop is different and for each loop is different. Yes, children, clear with this concept about for each and for. For is for regular and for each is only for arrays. This is the difference. Okay, so think and think 4.6 also over. We can go to the next one. How will you react if one of your file or folder is accessed and manipulated without your permission? In tech concept, we are seeing about the file permissions and all, right? So, in 4.8 activity, you are having a question. How will you react if you are having any your own items? Okay, if you are without your permission, if you are any of your friends is without your permission, if you are there accessing your anything, what will be your reaction? You want to write it by your own, okay? So what is your reaction? You write it. Don't write your friend's reaction. Okay. What is been your thought? You write that. Okay. If any file or folder is accessed and manipulated by anyone without your permission, what will be your reaction? You can able to write this, I think so. Yes. You can enter into the recap session now. Recap session. Match the following. First question. Super global. Answer, which is related to super global, array loop, predefined arrays, get method or array function. Second question, for each. Third one, array sum. Fourth one, file system. And fifth one, associative arrays. Yes, the answer for this is, for super global, the answer is get method. For for each, the answer is array loop. Yes, for each is only used for array loop. Second one, array sum is a array function. File system is a predefined PHP function. And associative array is arrays with string as index. Yes, we are having a numerical arrays. An associative array is an array with string as index. This is the answer for match the following. Clear with this? Once again, I'll say super global, it is used for get method. For each is used in only array loops. Array sum, it is an array function. File system, it is a predefined PHP function. And associative arrays, arrays with string as index. Yes, children, you have written the match the following. I hope you completed the match the following and you are clear with the concept of all the things which is given in this. Yes. We can enter into the next one. The next one is, answer the following. Define a function and write its syntax with example. Yes, so this is the definition of a function. A function is a subprogram designed to perform a specific task and return a value. What is a function? A function is a subprogram designed to perform a specific task and return a value. There are two types of functions, predefined functions and user-defined functions. The syntax to define the function is function, function name, code for execution. So what is a function? A function is a subprogram designed to perform a specific task and return a value. There are two types of functions, predefined functions and user-defined functions. The syntax to define function is function name, code for execution. And example program, this is the example program, starts with PHP, function send message, this is a function name and code for execution, print I have reached. And we are calling the function send message in the program. And the program is being closed. This is the example program for function in PHP. Yes, children, we are going to the next. What is the significance of parameters in a function argument? Parameters are information that is given as input to a function. So what is the significance of parameter? Parameters are information that is given as an input to a function. This is the answer for the second question. That is the second question. Once again, I'll repeat it. Second question is, what is the significance of parameters in a function argument? Parameters are information that is given as an input to a function. See, listen, children, all the answer the following, you want to write it in your CW note. Classwork note. So first question also from the answer in brief. Okay, define a function. From here, you want to write it in your classwork note. That is CW note. Got it? Answer the following and all. You want to write it in your CW. Don't write it in the book itself. If you are going to write it in the book, you want to copy it in your CW as you do it while you are in school. Got it? So all the answer the following, write it in your CW note. Yes. So second question answer, parameters are information that is given as an input to a function. All have written this. You can see the third question in the next video.